You can't prove Newton's laws. You can't prove Einstein's relativity. You can't prove Darwin's theory of natural selection. Why? And why do we put our trust in something we can't prove? And if we can't prove bees, then what can we prove? We're going to learn about all that and much more today. Let's begin. Hi, my name is Pranav. You're watching Science is Dope. Let's go back to some 6th grade math for a second. Remember the Pythagoras theorem? For any right triangle ABC, AB squared plus BC squared equals AC squared. That can be proven to be true. And here's the proof. Now let's appreciate what the word proof means here. Tomorrow, if you were to find a right triangle that no one has seen before and you measure its sides, then this relation between its sides is guaranteed. This relation is 100% true no matter what. That's what a proof is. 100% true. It's impossible to find a right triangle whose sides don't meet this relation. There are other theorems in geometry, other relations in algebra, all of which can be proved to 100%. So you can prove stuff in math. Why can't you do so in science? Let's first go back and see why math allows this. Consider this most basic arithmetic. Why is this relation true? Is it because if you had one apple and you added one more apple to it, you get two apples? I mean, that's true, but that's not why this relation is true. This is true because that's how the number 2 is defined. When you count 1 up from 1, you get 2. And when you count 1 more up from there, you get 3. Those are definitions. And from these two definitions, we automatically get the relation 1 plus 2 equals 3. This is how math works. You have a base of definitions and axioms, and from there you combine them to get these results and theorems. And to prove them, you just have to build backwards to these definitions. Science, however, doesn't have any definitions to start with. Instead of that, we have inputs from reality. But reality doesn't hand these inputs to you. You have to observe it and see what it gives you. In other words, you have to collect evidence. Okay, you make a bunch of observations and you notice that these observations aren't random. They seem to be following a pattern. So you try to model this pattern in hypotheses and theories and laws. You observe a bunch of swans, they're all white. So you model this pattern in a hypothesis, all swans are white. But how do you prove this? You'd have to make an infinite number of observations across the world, which isn't practical, but even if you do that, you've only verified the model for all the cases in the present. You'd have to keep making observations in the future forever. Scientific models like these, therefore, can never reach 100% certainty. There will always be some uncertainty. By the way, a species of black swan was discovered in Australia in the late 1600s. So I hope you understand why there are no proofs in science. There are only verifications and falsifications. And how do you verify or falsify an idea? By making observations. By collecting evidence. In math, we can talk in terms of proof, but in science, we can only talk in terms of evidence. Proof is the whole truth, while evidence is only a piece of that truth. All branches of knowledge that are contained within themselves, that is, you don't have to look outside to learn stuff, are called formal sciences. Similarly, branches of knowledge that are not self-contained, that model reality or the nature of something, they're called natural sciences or empirical sciences. Science is an empirical science. I know it's a bit confusing because the word science is used here and here, but I hope this diagram clears it out. Formal sciences include things like math and logic. Natural sciences include stuff like physics, chemistry, biology, economics, sociology, psychology, etc. Anything where you're trying to study things in the real world. These work on evidence, empirical evidence. And formal sciences work on proofs. The results of formal sciences are 100% certain, but for empirical sciences, they're not. The fact that the results of science are not 100% certain is something that conspiracy theorists and pseudoscience peddlers latch onto. They might say something like, science is always changing, why do you trust it? If you hear this, just ask them, do you have something better? They won't be able to give you an answer. There are more counters to this. Here's one. Let's look at the scientific method. We go from observations to a hypothesis, and we refine these models constantly through testing. This testing cycle is never ending, and every time we make a new observation that our current models can't explain, we refine our models so that they can. This way, new observations improve our models. They don't just change them. Science doesn't keep changing, it keeps improving. Anyone who makes this argument is ignoring the fact that there is progress in science. Whatever pseudoscience they're endorsing, can they say the same? I don't think so. Now, when it comes to testing, there is a lot that needs to be talked about, like how is testing done? What criteria does it take for an idea to be accepted by science? And what separates science from pseudoscience? This is also an area where religious and spiritual leaders tend to make a huge blunder. And I think that requires its own separate dedicated video. So stay tuned for that. People tend to throw around this phrase a lot, scientific proof. Even in some science magazines and articles, I've seen it being used casually. Whenever you see this kind of usage, just know that that's not how science works. In fact, that's not how any empirical study works. They work on evidence, not proof. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.